Hello. My name is Soly. I'm from the Philippines. I've been all the way, and I've never been here. In fact, I saw Jason on YouTube, and then I called up the Washington Adams Center, and I asked them, the corporate office anyway, and I asked them, give me the number of that guy. I said, you know, I'm talking to him, and I did. I think I must have called him about 2 or 3 times. I think, you know, oh, this is the nag again. Anyway, my story starts last year. I had brain surgery. Okay, here in the States, at Johns Hopkins. This was exactly in July. Okay, because I had a tumor sitting on top of my brain, actually of the cranium, and then your brain isn't exactly on top of your, you know, right out of the cranium. They have something called meninges, which is like a tissue. Okay, and my tumor was sitting right on top of it, okay, on the right side. So I was, by the time they brought me, my sister-in-law anyway, she's a nurse, they brought me to the emergency, I was already what they would call in an altered mental state. Like, I didn't know, I couldn't walk straight, I couldn't stand up. My vision, I mean, I could hear them talking, but I couldn't see them, although my eyes were open. And anyway, to make a long story short, they brought me to Johns Hopkins. I had an 8-hour surgery, And when I woke up, my whole left side was paralyzed. Oh. And I couldn't remember a lot of things. You know, I had amnesia. So anyway, I stayed in Johns Hopkins for a week. Then they brought me back here to New Jersey. I had rehab first in St. Joe in Wayne, but I plateaued, and they said, we have to release her, we can't do anything anymore for her. She's not responding. So they moved me to another location at Mary Hart, and that's where I spent, you know, all the way to September, or the end of September or October. And well, I did learn, you know, from being not being able to move, I graduated to a wheelchair. And then eventually I got to a walker, and then they could release me. But I still had, you know, I couldn't open my computer. I had forgotten how to open my computer. I'd forgotten how to open my iPad. I'm an industrial designer, and I couldn't do anything. Okay, so I decided, no, I might as well go to the Philippines because, you know, there's nothing more. And besides, they were simply pumping me with too much medicines. I had steroids to start with. I was getting depressed. I wanted to jump off the window. And so they gave me a psychiatrist. And I told the psychiatrist, get out of here. You're not telling me anything new. So they put me on my pills, which kept me happy. But you forget the here and now. You know, when you're taking a happy pill, you suddenly stop, you're eating, you forget you're eating. You forget the here and now. I think that's basically what drug addicts go through. They forget the here and now, but they're happy. So, because in short, I went back to the Philippines, and in December, some Korean lady said, why don't you try, in the Philippines, you know, I was going to an acupuncturist because I would sit for 5 minutes and I would, you know, swell, you know, from the waist down. I was so big. I looked like I was 5 months pregnant, you know, because of the drugs that they had me on. My blood pressure, I was taking 2 blood pressure medication, you know, one a diuretic and another one to, you know, normalize my blood pressure. I was a mess, okay? So anyway, this acupuncturist said, you know, there was a lady said that gave me these samples. Why did you try it? So I did. You know, December, January, February, by the mid, you know, beginning of March, it was like a whole curtain was lifted off my brain. my brain didn't feel like it was empty anymore. I could remember things. Mm-hmm. You know, I brought back my welcome cards. Mm-hmm. Get well cards. None of the signatures I knew. I mean, I didn't know anybody who, you know, sent those cards. So really, you know, I mean, lucky for me, I knew my direct family members. But that's about it. You know, I didn't know my friends. So, you know, it was like that. And then I just kept on getting better and better on Hemohim. And then, so in March, April, I said, okay, I want to be a member. And they said, I'm sorry, you know, they tried to put me into Korea, the Philippines isn't open yet. They're not going to open until this year. Okay, so there was nothing that they could do. So finally, I found a loophole. I could register in the States. Okay, so I got on the website, and I registered. And I said, I told them, look, I'm already a member. You know, I'm going to the States in July. And I said, for my checkout. And I said, you know, I might as well go and, you know, see a center. I've never seen a center. You know, I'll meet some Academy members and all that. So I did. In the meantime, they said they didn't have any material in English in the Philippines. So I pieced together, you know, what little they could, and then I helped them put together material in English that we could distribute to people. Plus, they brought me around the provinces in the Philippines. So now I do when they do presentations to the provinces, I'm the one that presents Hemohim. Okay.
Wow, that was amazing.
Yeah. Wasn't that amazing?
Yeah.
Thank God. That's really amazing. I just met her this evening.